long day of shooting. It's nothing like just relaxing a little bit. But I remember a good old time when I didn't even have a television show. When all this was just this. I didn't have anything to do with it. I was a low rent, no account, lazy paper boy, pusher in the company. Well, hello there, Chet Brothers.
Hi, Arnie Carmichael. How are you?
I'm good. Tough day at work today, wasn't it?
It was. Did you hear there's a new positioning opening up on the show?
Yeah, I heard they finally fired Ted. Good riddance, too. Boring conversations with Ted Weberwaddle.
Really?
Awful show.
Ridiculous name, too.
I know.
I think that I'm interested in going out for the position.
You have no chance, Brothers. Get off my Kool-Aid. That's all mine. I'm taking it.
I think not. Lloyd said that I have real potential and good talent. I think I have a good chance for getting it.
Lloyd is a blind cameraman. I'm not actually even sure why we employ him.
Yes, well, he's said that I've got the talent, and I think that I've got the looks for it, too.
He's been there for 90 years. It's a surprise that he doesn't even have his own TV show right now.
He could never have a TV show. He doesn't know what he's doing.
True, but you're in the same category, you and Lloyd. You don't have the charisma and the talent needed to become a humongous television star.
You have no talent, you're just a simple mailboy. What makes you think you have the brains for the job?
That is exactly how Tom Brokaw made his big break. He started as a mailboy and worked his way steadily up the chain. Actually, there wasn't even a steady working up the chain. They saw him, they said, Tom Brokaw, you're mine. Television show, now. Boom, there, done. I'm the Tom Brokaw of the Channel 7 news team.
Well, if you think so, then I think that we should have a little competition to decide who's the better-looking man for the job.
Well, what do you have in mind?
I don't know. I say maybe walking up to that handsome young woman and asking her who's the better-looking man.
A contest that I will invariably win. But you are
out. We will see. We will see.
You're going down, Brothers. I don't even know why you try to fight this.
You stand no chance. I can't get my jacket on.
Well, it's on now.
It's gonna be on when we get over to her.
Fix your collar. I don't want you to have any sort of excuse to not lose this.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right.
Excuse me, beautiful Missy. I need you to settle a debate between me and my kind of so-called friend. We need to know which one of us is better looking.
Well, I don't know either of you. You look much more like a mustache. And you, your facial hair is unruly.
That's right, unruly. But what we need to know, should an apocalypse happen right now and it would make us inhibited to do our television show, is which one of us is better looking so that way we can gloat when we're in heaven, or hell, or both.
That's a hard decision, but I would have to say this one. He looks more
funny. Ha! See, I win. It's your sideburns that make you look stupid.
These sideburns are going to accentuate the mustache that they give me as soon as I become a humongous television personality.
Not after I win these competitions and take the job from you.
What competitions? You name the next one, Brothers.
Well, then you're in for it. I say, ping pong.
Well, sir, you may have just bitten off more than you can chew. Because I also play ping pong.
Well, in my freshman college class, was a champion of the state.
You've never even played ping pong in your whole life. You carry that around a pet in your jacket so it looks like you have more muscles.
Sure, sure. I'll do my talking on the ping pong field.
Well, all right then. Good luck to you, Brothers.
Good luck to you, loser.
You have good a chance of winning at this as you do a man with no chances does.
You stand no chance. I'm a master at ping pong.
I'm the master of 6 ping pongs in 9 different languages.
You're the master of being a little princess when it comes to battles.
My mother always told me I was a princess.
Well, let's get it on.
Alright, Brothers. There's only one rule. You must return the ball. If you fail to hit the ball, you lose. But not the whole game. You just lose a point. And then I would make a point. And vice versa, should I miss the ball, which won't happen, and then you hit it past me, you would gain a point.
Sounds fair to me, because I don't think you're going to be able to return the ball.
I've never missed a ball in my life.
Yeah, right, like when you were 6.
That's right. Ha! Clear that I have underestimated you, Crothers.
You hit the ball like a little girl.
You have the skills of a Jedi warrior. Awesome.
I heard you.
Ha! Never. I don't need to know.
That's a point for me, Mr. the Mister.
I still returned it. It's 1-1 now, Crothers. Ha! Ha!
Seems that would be a point for you.
You failed to return it to me, thus making it mine.
You failed to hit it.
2-2.
This is quite a close game. I didn't think you had it in you.
Oh, I most definitely had it in me the whole time. You see this? You see how exuberant and excited I am? I want this, Crothers.
Well, it's mine. You stand no chance.
Never. It will never be yours. As long as this ball bounces, it's like every beat in my heart.
Ha! Oh, another point for you, my faithful competitor.
You better dress it up.
Take that! Aha!
Ah!
And one for me.
Yes, sir. See,
off your head.
Off nice face, head.
I don't think
you.
That.
That's technically on your side. I feel like there might be some gray area, but that was definitely you. All right, Crothers.
Next point wins.
Next point wins.
Tie game. What are you doing?
Stretching.
I'm wasting my time. Ah! No!
Yes!
No!
Yes! Tied up, 1-1. And throwing your balls in my face isn't gonna do anything.
I think it will. You're going down to the next match.
Alright.
Name your game.
Pose off. To music.
You stand. No chance.
Are you ready for this, Crothers?
You made the best poser win.
Then don your newscaster shades. Hit it!
True. I'll see you tomorrow.
Hey, Chet.
Yes?
You look good out there. I'm proud of you.
Thanks.
Have a good one. I wonder whatever happened to that character, Carruthers. He's a great guy. Really hope things turned out for him.
Damn you, Carmichael!